So hello guys, welcome back to the developer school again. Today we will talk about the sign up process. Okay, what is the sign up process and why it is important? We will discuss gonna in this video. So now first of all, like why this is important to you to be having the knowledge about the sign up process. So suppose that like if I am just going over the chat GPT and I will tell him like I will give him the form, like please do the validations of it. Then I will ask the controller code for that, and then I will make it route and all of the things. So then all of the things can be done by the chat GPT. But what chat GPT cannot do, this is about that. Okay, so I will gonna show you one of the registered sign up form which we have. So you know what, in the recent video we have talked about the layout setups and all which we have did recently. In that we have talked about the all of the methods available with the Laravel Blade template engine, which help us to like creating a separate layout for every separate file. So far so did we have did that thing, and I just tried to explain you all of those things. In my recent video I have comment from one user that I am speaking a little bit fast, so I just try to speak over some bit of pauses so that you guys can understand better me. So my first motive is not gaining the amount, not gaining the revenue, not gaining the reviewers, not gaining the subscriber. I just would like to share my entire knowledge with you guys so that one day if you become something, you remember that one buddy from the developer school help you to learn something else inside the Laravel. So this is my first of motive. And if you are new to our channel, please like, subscribe, share my channel with your friends so that I get the motivation from there, so that I will gonna create some amazing videos like that. So this one is the form. Now suppose that if you are going to a company for an interview, so interviewer will ask you some basic questions. Okay, these questions are for the entrance, for the 1 to 2 years experience of the persons. Why? Because for that we should have to be know about, like this person has to be a knowledge of actual coding or not, like he has the knowledge or she has the knowledge about the Laravel, about the PHP, about the database and all. So in that interview will gonna ask you like what is PHP, what is Laravel, why Laravel, what is QJobs, what are schedulers, how to use them, signatures and so other things and all. But you know what, if you are going over to the giving like a interview over a good approach or a good level, so then what companies want from you, what interviewers want from you is all about the practical knowledge of everything. What I mean by the practical, this is the practical is all about, like this form can be filled up by the chat GPT, can be made by the chat GPT, but we have to be know about the understanding. So here we have to be know about, like interviewer will ask you if you have to make a sign up form. If sign up form has a 3 fields or 4 fields like name, email, username and password, so and like agree terms, I agree accept terms and condition, so what, how you gonna made that, how you gonna made that. Okay, so for that you should have to reply about that, like what the fields you will gonna take, what validations you will gonna know about it, what validation you will gonna make it here and all of the things. So let's give me an example of it. Suppose that we are making one register form here. So first of all we have to take the username. Now for the username we have to tell the interviewer that we gonna take a worker field with the 255 limit, which is the maximum limit inside the SQL for the worker. Why? Because we know that nobody has the name like Chuttu Swami, Muttu Swami, Ben Gopal Haiyar, which is told inside the Dhamal movie, where like a candidate is telling the his name to the Arshad Warsi about like you have to hear my full name and all. So that one is the really very funny scan from there. So nobody has this much a bigger name. People's having the name between like 50 character, okay, 100 character, more than, not more than this. So that is sufficient to be making a field with 255 characters. This way your interview will get this know, like you have the knowledge of database and you are understanding that as well. Now you have to go with the other field. The other field is name, email. What with the email? Now this email field has to be again 255 character, and then this is the worker. Why worker? Worker means the where we can store variables and characters as well. So we are using the worker. Now with the username, we are again going with the 255 characters. We can also do it with the 100 characters and all, but we are taking this as like we are making a very good and big application where we should have to take it 255. Now you will go with the password as well. For the password, we gonna again save like 32-bit password or 64-bit kinds of passwords are there with the hashing number. So we can use again 255 characters limit in the varchar, and we will gonna store our password. But now you know what, with the basic functionality and understanding of this, we have to be know about this, like email has to be unique, because a person Govind Kumawat cannot have multiple emails with the same ID. Like if I was typing this mp17govind96@gmail.com, where you can mail your CVs to us and get the chance to give your interview over the developer school. Okay, so this cannot be have the multiple email ID. So this is the field have to be unique inside your database. Okay, then we are going with the username as well, and username has to be also unique. So that's the way we are just creating this like only. Okay, so what is to mean it be here? It is to be mean it be here, like we will mean up gonna make two fields unique here with the alternate field, which is our primary ID and all. So let's go. I was gonna open my XAMPP. This one is my XAMPP window. Okay. Let me start Apache and MySQL. If you don't know about XAMPP, you can like mention me in the comment box. I will let you know about the XAMPP and we will go further with that. Okay. So I have just started. Now I will click over localhost and phpMyAdmin. So then one local phpMyAdmin has been open over my localhost. It mean it has to be mean like over my local environment. Okay, so I am just creating one database which name is Laravel. Okay, so I just created one database here. So you know now how to create a database. Okay, now I would like to make one table. Okay, so I want to make the table name users. Okay, so this is the users. I just want to create it. Okay, so I have just created one table here. So now we have to be know about like what fields we can take. We can take ID, we can take what, we can take name, we can take we can take email, we can take usernames, we can take create password, update password, is active, is deleted fields and all. So this is the basics one. So now we will not gonna create any table just from this. We will gonna use and understand the migration in our upcoming video. So this is all about today. Here we just learn about what is the actual process of the registration to be user while taking the parameters. Now let's talk about it further. You know what, inside the videos and all, like the you have just tell the interviewer like we will take these of the fields. Now you have to tell, I will submit this form with the form submit. I will take my form as a post. Okay, I just use @CSRF there. Then your interviewer will ask, what is the mean of @CSRF? So it was a kind of a middleware which working as a like between your request. It has a unique token that has been identified the middleware, and if the token is correct, then you can directly interact with your application. Otherwise, you can't. Okay, so this is like two-factor kind of an authentication or a between a layer between your code and your database, so that like you can safely insert your database. So if interviewer will ask like can we have to use @CSRF with GET method, so you have to tell no, because CSRF is protecting you to be from SQL injection, not from the getting the data. Because suppose that I have one account number from the SBI, if somebody get my account number, what he can do? He can only deposit money inside that, he cannot withdraw from it. But in we are going with the like database, we have to stop user to like put data inside our database. And if he want to get the data from our database, then we will make some middlewares there, which will be authentication middlewares. So they will grant the permission to the user to get data just if they have the authentication token, which we will gonna create with using passport and with our auth middleware as well. So this is about that. Okay, so after that we will gonna what do what we will save our form. For that we will gonna make a request. Request will validate the actual form and will save your will provide you the back the if you have any kind of like error is there. Okay, and then we will show with the @error method those errors. So this is the complete process of it, and if everything was successful, we will gonna use hash and convert this password in hash and save in the database. So if you can able to explain like this to your interviewer, he will get this understand, okay, this buddy has the knowledge about actually the database and all. So this is all about for today in this okay chapter of understanding the sign up. Now let's start doing a sign up from here. Okay, so this is one I think so